Today, Hamish's younger daughter, Janet, lives in France, and his friend, John Berger, one of the great European writers of our day, is presently overseeing the translation of Hamish's war elegies into French. And he's working with two French people in Montauban, Emmanuel and Helen Favre. And they've sent us the first elegy translated into French. And tonight, we have our special guest, Régine Lafay, who's going to read this poem for the first time. And by strange chance, she was a student of mine in Dundee 40 years ago. And when I gave her the information, I didn't know that. So here is Régine. No, not 40 years. I'm sorry. Yes, first, in English, Dr. Ian Kerr, an old friend of Hamish's, a young friend of Hamish's, will read it in English.
This is the first elegy. End of a campaign. There are many dead in the brutish desert who lie uneasy among the scrub in this landscape of half-wit, stunted ill will. But the dead land is insatiate and necropolis. Sand is blowing about still. Many who, for various reasons, or because of mere unanswerable compulsion, came here and fought among the clutching gravestones, shivered and sweated, cried out, suffered thirst, were stoically silent, cursed the spittering machine guns, were homesick for Europe, and fast embedded in quicksand of Africa, agonized and died. And sleep now, sleep here, the sleep of the dust. There were our own, there were the others. Their deaths were like their lives, human and animal. There were no gods and precious few heroes. What they regretted when they died had nothing to do with race and leader, realm indivisible, labored Augustan speeches, or vague imperial heritage. They saw through that guff before the axe fell. Their longing turned to the lost world glimpsed in the memory of letters, an evening at the pictures in the friendly dark, two knowing conspirators smiling and whispering secrets, or else a family gathering in the homely kitchen with mum so proud of her boys in uniform. Their thoughts trembled between moments of estrangement and ecstatic moments of reconciliation, and their desire crucified itself against the unutterable shadow of someone whose photo was in their wallets. Then death made his incision. There were our own, there were the others. Therefore, minding the great word of Glencoe's son, that we should not disfigure ourselves with villainy or hatred, and seeing that all have gone down like curs into anonymous silence, I will bear witness, for I knew the others. Seeing that literal and interior are alike indifferent, and the birds are drawn again to our welcoming north, why should I not sing them, the dead, the innocent?
First, I want to establish it was not 40 years ago. Not quite. La fin d'une campagne, de nombreux morts dans le désert bestial, gisent inconfortables parmi les broussailles de ce paysage desséché à la mauvaise volonté imbécile. Car la terre des morts est insatiable et nécrophile. Le sable ondule sans bruit. Beaucoup sont ceux qui, pour diverses raisons, ou contraints et forcés, vinrent ici et combattirent au milieu des pierres tombales, les agrippants, grelottèrent et suèrent, crièrent, souffrirent de la soif, stoïques et silencieux, maudirent leurs mitraillettes et nostalgiques de l'Europe, s'enfoncèrent rapidement dans les sables mouvants de l'Afrique, agonisèrent et moururent. Et dorment maintenant, dorment en ce lieu du sommeil de la poussière. Il y a les nôtres, il y a les autres. Leurs morts furent comme leur vie, humaines et animales. Ils ne furent pas des dieux, et très peu furent des héros. Lorsqu'ils moururent, leur regret n'avait plus rien à voir avec des notions de race et de chef, de royaume indivisible, de pompeux discours d'Auguste ou un quelconque héritage impérial. Ils avaient senti la supercherie bien avant que le couperet ne tombe. Leur désir se tournait vers ce paradis perdu, entreaperçu dans la mémoire de leurs lettres. Un soir au cinéma, dans le noir complice, deux conspirateurs se sourient et se chuchotent des secrets. Ou alors, une famille se réunit dans la chaleur de la cuisine, où maman est si fière de ses gars en uniforme. Leurs souvenirs oscillaient entre les moments de discorde et l'extase de la réconciliation, et leurs désirs crucifiés sur l'ombre indicible d'une photo dans leur portefeuille. Alors la mort a tranché. Il y a eu les nôtres, il y a eu les autres. C'est pourquoi me revient la parole merveilleuse du fils de Glencore, selon laquelle nous ne devons laisser une haine infâme nous défigurer, voyant que tous, méprisés comme des chiens, sont tombés dans l'oubli. Je serai le témoin, car j'ai connu les autres. Si le littoral et l'intérieur s'en désintéressent et que les oiseaux sont toujours attirés par le nord accueillant, pourquoi ne les chanterai-je pas, eux, les morts, les innocents ?